Well, good morning, everybody. It's Monday, December 13th. Hope you had a great weekend. Hope you were able to be part of church. Hope you were able to tune in to our epic Christmas series. That will continue again this coming Sunday, the 19th. We'll see another aspect of an epic Christmas. Now, I want to remind you, I'm going to do this every day between now and December 24th, that we have our Christmas Eve services coming up. Now, if you want to attend live in person at our Sioux campus, there'll be one at 4 o'clock and 6 o'clock. At our Gaylor campus, there'll be one at 2 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Now, we're designing this one at our Gaylor campus different than we've ever done before. I hope it works. We'll see. Now, we're also going to be online live from the Gaylor campus at 4 o'clock and 6 o'clock. So wherever you are, I hope you'll be part. I hope you'll tell others so they can be part as well. Well, we spent a long time in these check-ins talking about why God chose Joseph. We spent a long time looking at the very birth of Jesus. Now, let's see the role the angels and the shepherds played. So let me begin by reading Luke chapter 2, verses 8 and 9. In the same region, there were some shepherds staying out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock at night. And an angel of the Lord suddenly stood near them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were terribly frightened. Well, let me just point out a couple things. First, notice the shepherds on Christmas morning. Now, what I need you to understand is that often we kind of sit back and think, shepherds, what, well, you know, Jesus is our shepherd. What a wonderful person a shepherd must be. But the truth is that shepherds had very bad reputations in that day. One of the reasons is because their jobs would not allow them to keep all the ceremonial law, because what they had to do with the sheep would often disqualify them from being part of the ceremonial law. They were considered to be very unreliable. In fact, they were not even allowed to give testimony in court because it was said you could not trust a shepherd. Isn't it interesting that that's who Jesus or God chose to be the first witnesses outside of Mary and Joseph that Jesus had been born? The very first people who will hear the announcement will be guys who weren't even allowed to testify in court because they were seen as unreliable. But that's the pattern of God. Remember the first witnesses of the resurrected Christ? It was women. And in that day, the same thing was said about women. You couldn't trust them. They couldn't testify in court. But God loves to use people that most of society writes off. That's a great thing about our God. And that's what he does with these shepherds. By the way, these shepherds may have cared for sheep that would have been used for sacrifices, because Passover and all that would happen around Jerusalem and all the sacrifices that would happen. And how fitting would it be that the first people who hear the words that the Lamb of God had been born are those taking care of the lambs who are ultimately sacrificed, because this baby would now be the once and for all sacrifice. And with the shepherds, there's a shining. It says an angel appears to the shepherds. Now, more than likely, it's Gabriel. Now, why do I say that? Because he's the one that appeared to Zacharias in Luke 1, and he's the one that appeared to Mary in Luke 1. And more than likely, though his name's not given, he's the one that appeared to Joseph in the dream. And the angel comes to give the message. And what's the first response of the shepherds? They are terribly frightened. In fact, the Bible says they feared a great fear. By the way, that is the natural response in the Bible when anyone sees an angel. There was great fear. But the first words out of the angel's mouth, we'll see it tomorrow, will be this: fear not. And maybe today you're struggling with the fear. I hope those words will resonate with you. Fear not. And we'll see why tomorrow. Let's pray. Father, thank you for loving us. Thank you that you're a God who often uses individuals who society deems as unreliable. Thank you for using us. And I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I hope you'll share this on your Facebook page. Join us tomorrow as we see more of the conversation between the angel and the shepherds. Have a good day.